Welcome to Deming, New Mexico, and as you can see back here, Escapee's Dream Catcher RV Park. Join me today for this campground review and tour. If you are new to the channel, we invite you to hit that subscribe button down below and ring that notification bell for future videos. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. We really appreciate the support. And everybody, please hit that like button to help this video get seen on YouTube. This is a park of basic needs and not one of too many amenities. It's more about the convenience to the interstate, but y'all coming along with me and let's see what y'all think about this campground tour and review. This park is located just off of I-10 and has very easy on and off access to the interstate. You will also have easy access to Walmart and other basic needs while in the area. This is not a long-term park, but more of a pass-through with a few attractions in the area like City of Rock State Park. It's overall very clean and does cover all the basic camping needs. There is a total of 117 sites at this park, and short stays will typically be in the pull-through sites. Check-in here is noon, but they will let you come in early if your site is already open, and check-out time is at 11 a.m. We pay $28 per night for full hookups, including 50-amp service with our Escapee's membership. Now, let's get on with this tour and review of this campground.
So when you arrive at this park, you're going to come off of I-10, which you see right there, and you're going to come down this road. You're going to come to the Chevron and you're going to immediately take the left into the park where it says enter right here. So as you can see, very easy on and off from the interstate and very close to the interstate. Although you do not hear the interstate noise when you're in your RV, you will hear it when you're outside. And so once you turn into the park, you're going to come to this stop registration sign right here. You'll turn off your engine and basically you're parked outside of the activity center, but the main office door is in the back right here. We'll walk up to it. So here is where you will go to check in, and if you're here and the office is not open, they have after hours reservations right here, so you can do that. Or if you don't have a night already booked, you can actually do that right here as well. So it's really cool, and they got a campground map right here on the board, so you can see that when you come in. And also in here, actually behind this door here, is the activity building. But as you can see, because of the current pandemic situation, this is currently closed. So, but they do have different activities and gatherings like they do at the typical Escapee's park when these are available. So you go in, they do different games, meetings, get together, just different stuff. And this here just kind of gives you an overview of the whole park. So it is mostly pull through sites with some back ends on the back end that typically is your long-term people. But pretty much it's just a gravel parking lot with power, water, and sewer, and all the power here is 50, 30, 20 amp service. So, you know, it's just a parking lot to pull into and rest, but not too bad. So they do have a pretty good sized dog park here. As you can see, there is some damage on the back side here currently. My understanding is that has been there for a while, but it is a good size. The big thing is if you just got smaller dogs, you got to be careful with this damaged area, and there's also damage down in the corner just to make sure that your dogs don't get out. That is one of the strikes, though. It does need to be fixed because my understanding is it has been here for a while that way. So they do have a 24-hour laundry service that has a coded door, and once you enter the code, which I already have, you actually come in here and they've got a little sitting table for you, a little sink. Got some washers and got several dryers back here as well. A few more washers, one that is tore up. The price on these is actually pretty good, and I'll put that right here. So the washers are $1.25, the dryers are $1.25, so that's not too bad of a price. But, you know, small little laundry, but hey, it works. And here we have the 24-hour restroom shower houses. So I will go in again. I've already typed in the code, and I will show you the men's side. So here you see a couple of different sinks. You got a toilet here. You've got a shower here, plenty of room in there, looks pretty nice. And in here you got a handicapped accessible bathroom. So you got the toilet there, you got the railing, and also you've got the roll-in shower with the seat. So again, that is a pretty nice amenity. A little dated, but overall not bad. And here is our site. So here's a view down our driver's side, and here's a view down our passenger side. So as you can see, plenty of room in the sites. They are pulled through. I'll walk you through. So here you see the full hookups. You see the power going. You see the water. You see the sewer. I did put up our booster here, as you can see. And to give you an idea on the campground Wi-Fi, they have Tlingo, which is awful. I'll never tell nobody to get that. But AT&T offers 10 meg down, 17 meg up with the booster. Without, it is very slow. Verizon is 15 meg down and 12 meg up. So they're both pretty close, but that is no booster with the Verizon. So I'll walk you around the site here. See, very easy to level up, plenty of room. So we have been very happy with that. But again, you are just kind of in a gravel parking lot, but overall it serves the purpose.
If you are looking for a cheaper park that is a good place to rest your head and just have the basic needs and hookups, then this is definitely a good park for you. The convenience to the interstate is great, and there are a few sites to see in the area. Our stay here was okay overall. We had our basic needs met with the power, the water, the sewer. Good level site, so can't complain too much on that. But for the most part, this is a very basic park. And of the three escapees that we have stayed at now, this is probably our least favorite. There's just not a whole lot here, not a whole lot to see in the area, and not a whole lot of amenities here at the park to draw you in. But overall, like we say, it was an okay stay. Again, we appreciate y'all so much for watching today. Thanks, y'all. Bye.